I was first starting out, actually all my life, I was so eager for someone to just listen to me and believe in me. I was on my own, I had nothing but my demo tape. And when you're really, really young, most people don't take you seriously, so it was hard for me to get a break. Finally, a little bit after high school, I got an audition to be a background singer for Brenda K. Starr, who had a really big hit with a song called I Still Believe. And she hired me. And she took me under her wing, and she believed in me. Do you remember when I first came to the audition? I asked you, what are you doing? You said, you were real quiet. You excluded yourself from everybody.
Yeah.
And I said, what tape? You said, oh, a couple of demos that I cut up trying to get a record deal.
Right.
And I was like, can I hear? And I listened and I looked at you and I was like, why are you sitting back up for me? And you were like, well, because, you know, I got to pay my bills. And I was like, you should be like a huge star.
I went up to your room and there was like 9 girls there, remember?
Yes,
and, like,
I lived
4 cats or something like that. You had your cats. And I was like, where do you sleep? And there was a mattress on the floor.
It's just like now that I redid this song, I still believe. It's like when I listen to it, it has a new life and a new meaning to me. But when we sit here and talk, it totally reminds me of the times that we spent together and like how you really did believe in me. And you're going to do probably some one of my songs. We're talking about that.
Yeah, we talked about the song that's like meaning to me as well.
And it'll remind us of those days and
future sad.
So this is me and Trey.
What up, player?
On the road, trying to get through. I'll be there.
I can never get through it.
And neither could I. See, the problem is, Trey and I have known each other for so long that we have so many private jokes. And then when we're on stage, he just looks at me or does something when nobody else realizes it. And we both start laughing. Or, okay, sometimes I do the same thing to him. But that was one of the highlights of my show because he came out and, I don't know, he just had me laughing.
Pop superstar Mariah Carey has delighted hundreds of fans in a face-to-face meeting outside her Brisbane hotel.
The world's biggest selling recording artist, Mariah was greeted by frenzied fans. But with tight security, they could only watch through closed gates. Mariah's only Brisbane concert plays at the Entertainment Centre tomorrow night. She then goes on to Sydney, Melbourne and Perth.
One of the most memorable moments of my tour was actually off stage in Perth, Australia.